stocks in Asia see a disappointing end to the trading month as investors digest a slew of economic data in the region. The markets are particularly reacting to China's factory activity in May, which contracted for a second straight month. Beijing's official manufacturing PMI fell to 48.8, slipping further from the 49.2 in March. China's service sector activity also growing to its slowest pace in 4 months. The non-manufacturing PMI was down 54.5 from the 56.4 in April. The latest figures all but point to signs China's economic rebound might be losing steam. The world's second largest economy is seeking to recover this year after emerging from its strict COVID lockdowns in December. Taking a look now at major stock indices in the region, it's a sea of red, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng shedding 2.6%, falling to a new low this year. We're seeing the Nikkei 225 also retreating after Japan's April retail sales growth stood at 5% to miss expectations of 7%. The ASX 200 joining its peers, with Australia's hotter-than-expected inflation hitting 6.8% last month. Over in Europe, futures point to a lower open, led by the British FTSE 100. Checking now on Wall Street, the major indices are down in pre-market open as traders hold their breath for a vote on the U.S. debt ceiling deal. Overnight, we saw chip giant Nvidia hitting the $1 trillion market value, becoming only the ninth company on Wall Street to do so, before paring back gains to return to the $990 billion market cap. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Philippine banks see a slower growth in lending in April. Preliminary data from the central bank show while last month's lending activities among large banks grew 9.7% year-on-year, it was a touch lower than March's 10.2%. The Banco Central, however, says on a month-on-month seasonally adjusted basis, bank lending went up marginally by 0.6%. Thai business giant Chariun Pokphand, or CP Group, announces eyes investing $2.5 billion in agricultural technology development in the Philippines. CP Group officials made that commitment during their meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Tuesday. The company's investments will be stretched between 2023 and 2027, covering swine, poultry, and shrimp. It also committed to help modernize the local agri-sector by providing state-of-the-art technology and training to Filipino farmers. Marcos, meanwhile, assured the Thai conglomerate of the government's assistance as it rolls out its programs. The Philippines' electronics sector is optimistic for growth this year despite global headwinds. Semiconductor and Electronics Industries in the Philippines, or SEPI President Dan Lachica, said the sector stands to benefit from new technologies such as artificial intelligence. He also sought to allay concerns that AI may replace workers.
Whenever you have a new technology, on one hand, there's risk to existing jobs. But the nice thing is if you reskill, that's why AMDEV is so important. And of course, our member companies are well aware of that. So you reskill, you retool the workforce, and you equip them with new skills that can cope with the new products.
A multi-million dollar funding approved by the World Bank for a new fisheries initiative in the Philippines. The lender says the $176 million project will seek to improve fisheries management and production in coastal communities. It says the project will also help elevate the income of fisherfolk in the said areas. The World Bank's country director for the Philippines says the long-term goal is to improve resilience of communities in the coastal regions through thriving fish stocks, food security, and poverty reduction.